Good news for motorists: an oil price rollback set for Tuesday. Gasoline prices will drop by 85 centavos per liter, diesel by 75 centavos, and kerosene by 90 centavos. The rollback comes as forecasts point to weaker global demand, with China's latest economic stimulus measures falling short of expectations. The Philippine Transportation Department clarifies the new LRT1 extension does not directly connect to the Ninoy Aquino International Airport due to right-of-way issues. While the extension offers stations near key transport hubs like the Parañaque Integrated Terminal Exchange, the Ninoy Aquino Avenue station is still 2 to 4 kilometers away from the main gateway. The DOTR says it is exploring a monorail shuttle to connect the station to Naiya.
Look at the alignment on Google Map. Sa ilog yung alignment. So ang pinakamalapit na pwede pagtayuan ng istasyon na nasa kalsada na is yung kinatitirikan niya ngayong Ninoy Aquino Avenue Station. That is the closest it can get to the airport. So ang pwedeng gawing remedyo ng DOTR is to take up a spur line, a monorail, a shuttle train, but battery-operated shuttle train with rubber wheels, parang yung sa Hong Kong Disneyland, but a little bigger than that.
The Light Rail Manila Corporation, meanwhile, says it is working with local operators to provide shuttle services for those who need to be dropped or picked up from the station to the airport. The LRT1 Cavite Extension Project opened this past Saturday, connecting Baclaran Station in Pasay to Dr. Santos Station in Sucat, Parañaque. Minimum wage earners in Eastern Visayas getting a pay hike. The Regional Tripartite Wages and Productivity Board has approved a 30 peso increase, bringing the region's daily minimum wage to 435 pesos. Meanwhile, the board also approved a 500 peso monthly wage increase for household workers who earn between 5,500 and 6,000 pesos. The adjustments are expected to benefit nearly 130,000 minimum wage earners and 57,000 domestic workers. Balacanang dismissing the claim of former President Rodrigo Duterte, it is using former Senator Antonio Trillanes to attack him. Pia Gutierrez now on the line with that story. Pia, over to you.
That's right, Carmina. Balacanang has dismissed former President Duterte's claims that the palace is behind former Senator Antonio Trillanes' attacks against the former president. Executive Secretary Lucas Bersamin told reporters that the claim of the former president was just a mere hallucination after Duterte lashed out against the Marcos administration and Trillanes during a live stream of his former spokesman, Attorney Salvador Panelo, saying that the former senator is allowing himself to be a pawn of Malacanang for money. Let's listen in.
Alam mo, mahirap pumatol na sa ganyan. Hallucination na yan.
Ano po, sir?
Hallucination.
All right. Carmina, we have yet to get the side of President Marcos Jr. on the claim of his predecessor, former President Duterte. But President Marcos actually led the 49th Philippine National Prayer Breakfast in Malacanang this morning. It's a national gathering of leaders from government, business, and religious groups focused on seeking divine guidance for the country's future and fostering a shared commitment to lead with integrity. Marcos Jr. says prayer to God is the most powerful tool to transform amid all the disasters that the country is facing right now. The event comes as the Philippines is severe challenges from a series of powerful storms which brought much devastation to many parts of the country. Marcos Jr. says the event has been a cornerstone of national reflection, a moment when leaders set aside titles and agenda and come together as equals in prayers. He said, he noted that the Philippines, as well as the rest of the world, face so much divisiveness in belief and politics, even generational and cultural differences. He also reminded future leaders that faith will help them navigate the uncharted waters of leadership and will bring them courage in times of doubt and will help them temper ambition with a sense of purpose greater than self. Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Pia Gutierrez there joining us on the line. With President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. confirming one fatality in Camarines Norte in the aftermath of Super Typhoon Pepito. The powerful storm left a trail of destruction across Luzon, with the Bicol region again badly hit. The National Disaster Management Agency reports more than 800,000 people have been affected by the storm.
One casualty too many. So that is unfortunate. However, I still would like to congratulate na kailangan pasalamatan natin lahat ng mga first responder, yung mga LGU, lahat ng mga nagtatrabaho na pang-anim na nila. Ito, I'm sure that they are exhausted. I am sure that they have done, they continue to do and work with as hard as they can.
Pepito made its first landfall in Panganiban, Catanduanes Saturday night, leaving homes severely damaged and many streets flooded. Local officials say Pepito is the strongest storm to hit the province this year.
Sa ngayon po, wala kaming kuryente. Pero yung nag-usimula kami ng clearing ng kalsada going to north, kasi doon ang tinamaan na masyado. Ang Catanduanes po, yung during the typhoon, before the typhoon, ang atin... ang ating evacuees ay 135,000 families or more than 100,000 individuals. Isang araw lang po yun. Kinabukasan, dahil maganda naman yung panahon, ay nagsisibalikan na yun sa kanilang bahay. Kahit sira ang bahay nila, kahit may tatlong yerong natira, ay mag-uumpisa na yung magkumpuni. Ang kailangan natin is tulong sa mga hardware materials like yero, plywood.
The Office of the Civil Defense says the country is in the midst of experiencing the effects of climate change. A string of six storms have battered the country in recent weeks.
Yung long-term damages, halimbawa po, bago pa itong Pepito, ang ulat sa amin is minimum of 10.6 billion pesos po yung mga napinsalang sa infrastruktura. Ibig sabihin yung mga tulay, mga kalye, yung mga ganun po. Baha-baha pong panahon yan. It will take time. Mahina po ang dalawa hanggang tatlong taon dyan. Sa pagnanawagan na po ang national government, ang DILG in particular, dapat sundin na nila yan. Napakaraming nabiktima dahil hindi po sumunod doon sa forced evacuation.